Hi guys, what's going on? Good to see you again in December. This is Oleg, your real estate broker with WinRebellio Comments. We're almost in holidays, almost Christmas and New Year coming up like in a couple days. And I decided to bring this episode not just to celebrate with you on my channel Christmas time. This is why I brought this Christmas tree for you guys. But because I want to tell you guys very important information which going to be reflect real estate market in 2022. And we see a lot of changes coming up. And I believe you guys should know first about this. You should know what's going to be happening. Stay tuned with me and let's jump in right to important data. I'd like to start with this article, Federal Press release from December 15, 2021. It's pretty much like a bomb dropped. And mainstream media pick up this right away. Bloomberg wrote article right on the spot on December 15. Fed doubles taper signals 3 2022 hikes in inflation pivot. So what it basically means, let's worry about inflation. Inflation is skyrocketing right now, and this is bad for our economy. And Feds have tools to fight with inflation. It's one of the tools they have, and they're going to be exercised, and they announced in this article, they're going to be increased interest rate. And they're planning to have 4 separate meetings in 2022. I'll show you guys graphs from the Bloomberg when they're going to see those meetings. And they decide to increase interest rate from 0% right now, and they kept 0% for a long time to boost economy, to keep going with the COVID and print a lot of money. But that printing a lot of money and boost our economy and keep interest rates zero, which makes money really cheap, and cheap money creates trigger to create inflation. So money doesn't really worth much anymore. So, and to offset that, to fight that, to keep inflation in a normal phase, like between 2-3%, so Feds definitely have to do something about that right now. So, and what they're going to do, they're going to increase in 2022 interest rate, and they're going to have 4 meetings for that. Probably we're gonna see first increase interest rate in March or April time in 2022, and that's going to be reflect mortgage interest rate increase as well. They're not related together exactly, but when we have cheap money, we have very low interest rate for mortgages as well, but we have money expensive, so banks most likely going to be increase mortgage rates as well following Feds, and we're gonna see this in the real estate market. And that's going to be reflect real estate market, and people are gonna be stop doing refinances. A lot of people actually who was on the edge to thinking about selling house, I think in the springtime they will move forward with selling property, because a buyer's power will decrease with increasing interest rate. And you guys know, like, if interest rate increase for 1%, so buyer's power decrease for 10%. So basically, if you have minimum sell price right now on east side $1.4 million, and if interest rate will increase for about 1%, so buyers can buy less house, if they will pay like $140,000 less to keep the same mortgage. And that's going to be reflect sellers who planning to sell property next year or near future. So I think that's going to be help for us, for our economy, and going to be help to reduce some steam with the hotness of this real estate market, and probably going to be bring some inventory specifically in springtime of 2022. I hope for that. But if you guys not agree with me, please put your comments below. I'd like to see your opinion as well about that. Fed's planning to increase interest rate from 0 to 0.75% in 2022. Probably by 2023, we're going to be increased up to 1.6%. That's a huge increase. It's pretty much 3 times increase, and that's increase going to be reflect mortgage rates for sure, and that's increase going to be reflect real estate market, not just in Seattle, Washington, or east side, pretty much in whole United States. And now let's talk about local real estate market, and I will start with Seattle. So what we see in the month of December, we have 0.4 months of inventory, and inventory dropped from 2020 to 2021 from 1.2 months to 0.4 months with 4% price increase year over year, and medium sell price right now $850,000 in all Seattle areas. Currently, 44% all homes in Seattle selling above asking price, and 24% selling at asking price. 76% of all homes in Seattle selling less than 15 days on the market. And as of selling in Seattle, about 90% right now. And you guys can see on this screen with me, so it's only about 8% of the homes did not close on time. That means buyers decided to not buy a house for any reason, like doesn't like after home inspections, or maybe appraisal did not appraise the property and they can walk away from this deal. I mean, buyers can have like thousands of different reasons to walk away from the deal. You guys can see this number decreased from 2020 and 2019 from 15%, 13% to 8%. That tells me we have more quality buyers in Seattle right now. So people who's actually getting under contract, they're more serious about buying property, and like 92% of all homes closing in Seattle. And now if we move to east side, all residential data, pretty much east side, it's east from Lake Washington. You guys can see we have right now 0.2 months of inventory, almost have no inventory, as with medium sell price $1,428,000, 35% increase year over year. 68% of all homes in Seattle's east side selling above asking price, and 10% selling at asking price. This information tells me, guys, people fight for get house on the east side right now. So we have a huge demand. We pretty much have no inventory at all, and we have a lot of buyers wants to fight for this house and just buy this house right now in Seattle's east side. 85% of all homes in Seattle's east side selling less than 15 days on the market, and odds of selling, of course, 94%, and 2% homes did not close after signing mutual agreement. If you guys analyze data what's happening in December for last 10 years, the data shows in average we have about 1,000 homes on the market in Seattle's east side. 1,000 homes was available every year, except exceptions was last year when the COVID hit, and we have about 200 homes. But this year, for all east side, we have only 100 homes. All east side, it means for all cities like Mercer Island, Bellevue, Kirkland, Redmond, Issaquah, Sammamish, Bustle, Newcastle, for all those cities, we have only 100 homes. I did not see this happening with last 20 years I'm practicing real estate in this area. With that, guys, if we're going to have interest rate increase for mortgages in 2022, probably about March or April, this information going to be stimulate the sellers to list property and sell, because buyer's power going to be decreased in the future. So we're gonna see probably more inventory on the market, and that's gonna be help everybody. It will help those buyers to find the house, this home sweet home. They will be able to choose the property like in a normal market, choose it, buy it, find properties they actually like to live, like to buy, not just like any house. And I hope it's gonna be help everybody in 2022, and we're going to see healthy economy. And with that, guys, Merry Christmas, Happy New Year. I wish you all the best, and thank you so much, guys, for being with me in 2021. Until next time, next market update in January 2022. Have a fantastic week, Merry Christmas, and Happy Holidays.